word resurrection पर focus रखते हैं इसलिए.
And that's why we focus on the word resurrection.
जिसका मायना है मुर्दों में से जी उठना.
The meaning of which is to rise up from the dead.
तो बाइबल में पाया जाता है.
You find that in the Bible.
Easter word जब लोग बोलते हैं तो वो भी जी उठने की actually बात कर रहे हैं.
When people say the word Easter, that's exactly what they're talking about, the rising up from the dead of Jesus.
इतिहासिक तौर पर इस word का किसी और बात को लेना देना है.
Maybe historically this word has connection with something else.
और जब आप खुदा यीशु को याद करते हो इस्तेमाल करते हो तो इट्स ओके क्योंकि खुदा उनको यीशु को याद कर रहे
हैं. When you remember the Lord Jesus and use the word, the term, it's fine.
अगर आप resurrection करते हैं तो आप बहुत precisely बाइबल के मुताबिक हो जाते हैं.
And if you use the word resurrection, then you become biblically very precise.
Amen.
Amen.
जो कुछ भी word इस्तेमाल किया जाए याद रखें कि प्रभु यीशु मसीह के मुर्दों में से जी उठने की बात कर रहे हैं.
Whichever word or term you use, remember we are remembering the Lord Jesus rising up from the dead.
ये जो है बहुत ही emotional त्यौहार है actually.
Actually, this is a very emotional celebration.
बड़े sentiment जुड़े हुए हैं इसके साथ.
There are many sentiments, भावनाएं that are associated.
हर साल मैं बताता हूँ कि सिर्फ यीशु मसीह के तीन दिन मनाए जाते हैं, हर शख्स के दो दिन सिर्फ मनाए जाते हैं.
Every year I tell you it is only Jesus for whom we celebrate 3 days. Every other human is celebrated on 2 days.
सबका जन्म और मरण दिन मनाया जाता है, प्रभु यीशु मसीह का जन्म मरण और जी उठना तीनों मनाया जाता
है. Everyone's birthday and death anniversary is celebrated, but for Jesus, his birth, his resurrection and his death and his resurrection are celebrated 3 days.
हमारे विश्वास को हमारे ईमान को दूसरों से भिन्न ऑफर कर देता है.
It is the resurrection of Christ that separates our faith from all other faiths and philosophies.
जब आप इन अनुच्छेदों को हिस्सों को पढ़ेंगे जहां पर प्रभु यीशु जी उठे हैं तो बड़े इमोशंस बड़े जो है रिएक्शंस नजर आएंगे.
And that is why when you read these scriptures, these passages, you will find that there are many emotions associated with the resurrection.
आप मरकुस की इंजील उसका 16 अध्याय उसकी पहली तीन आयतों का अगर ध्यान दे तो
if you look at the first three verses of Mark 16
तो आप देखेंगे वहां पर बहनों का वहां पर जिक्र होता है.
Sisters are mentioned there.
Mary Magdalene और Salome और दूसरे जो हैं बहनें वहां पर कब्र पर जा रही हैं.
There's Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, Salome, other sisters together.
तो ये बहनें जो हैं लिखा है सुबह तड़के उठ जाती हैं भोर में उठ जाती हैं और यीशु की कब्र की ओर हेस्टली बड़े बड़े जो हैं तेजी से दौड़ते हुए वहां पर पहुंचती हैं.
And so it is written that these sisters wake up before dawn, they get the spices and the balms together and they go towards the tomb of Jesus.
जब भाई सो रहे थे
When the brothers were sleeping,
शागिर्द खराटे ले रहे थे.
When the disciples were snoring,
early morning सुबह तड़के के वक्त बहनें कब्र सामने गई हैं उस समय.
Early in the morning, भोर के वक्त it's the sisters that went to the tomb.
अगर आप तड़के भोर के वक्त अंधेरे के वक्त आपको कब्रिस्तान जाना है तो आपके अंदर जिगरा होना चाहिए.
If you want to wake up before it's morning time while it's still dark and go towards the graveyard, you must have a lot of courage.
जब सन्नाटा छा हुआ है, सब कुछ शांत है और कोई आपको देख नहीं रहा है, कोई आपको रास्ते में मिलता नहीं है, आपके अंदर दलेरी होनी चाहिए कि आप कब्रिस्तान में जा रहे हैं.
When it is quiet and there is no sound and no one on the way that you meet, you must have tremendous courage to go to the graveyard.
और बहनें वहां पर क्या करने जा रही हैं?
But what are the sisters going to do?
लिखा है उस हिस्से को पढ़ते हैं मत्तुस की इंजील 16 अध्याय पहली तीन पंक्तियों में कि वो यीशु के जिस्म पर सुगंधित वस्त्रें लगाने जा रहे हैं.
It is written if you follow in the book of Mark the first few verses that they are going to anoint Jesus' body with sweet spices.
Already जो निकोदिमस और दूसरे जो शख्स हैं जो सब उन्होंने 100 पाउंड पहले उन पर जो इंबामेंट किया है यीशु मसीह को दफनाने से पहले.
पहले से ही about 100 pounds of embalming material was applied on the body of Jesus by Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus.
तो ये यहूदी रवायत है, दस्तूर है, और उसी हिसाब से ये सारी सामग्री जो मुर्दा शव पर लगाई जाती है, तो वो पूरा आकार उनको दफनाया गया.
So this is the Jewish custom, and according to the Jewish custom, all this material was applied, and his body was embalmed, and he was placed in the tomb.
अब भोर का वक्त है, और सब लोग सो रहे हैं, और जाकर कब्रिस्तान में जा रहे हैं, और ये सब जो हैं शरीर पर जो है सामग्री लगानी इसके लिए भी हिम्मत आपको चाहिए.
And you know it's the morning time and you're going to go to the tomb, go to the dead body and apply spices on it. You must have courage.
अगर आप इस अनुच्छेद को पढ़ते तो वो क्यों जा रहे हैं ये काम करने के लिए?
If you read this scripture, this excerpt, you'll realize why are they going in the morning?
रास्ते में बातचीत हो रही है.
And they're speaking along the
way. बड़ी चिंता, उनको बड़ी फिक्र है.
And they are worried.
पत्थर कौन हटाएगा?
Who's going to move that big stone?
वहाँ पर कौन हमें मिलेगा?
Who will meet us there?
कैसे हम ये सब काम करेंगे?
How will we do our work?
क्यों करने जा रहे हैं वो वहाँ?
Why are they going to do this?
उनको है कि जो दस्तूर पूरा नहीं हुआ है अभी.
They feel that the custom, the ritual and rites have not been fulfilled yet.
आपको लगाया है अब तीसरे दिन जो हम पूरा काम कंप्लीट करना है पूरा जो समझ नहीं अभी लगाई नहीं गई है रवायत के मुताबिक उस रवायत को पूरा करना है हमको जाके.
A part was applied to the body, but now it's time to apply the rest of the material, the spices on the body. They want the full tradition to be fulfilled. They want the Jewish customs to be completely fulfilled. They feel that these things are incomplete. The brothers did not do it, other sisters did not do it, so we are going to complete it. They are very worried. They are very concerned. They have many doubts and many thoughts in their minds. Why? Because the work they feel is
incomplete.
These things that were to be done after the death of Jesus are still incomplete and they want to go complete. Even though Jesus had told them that he would rise up from the dead, they have not believed. They didn't take his words literally. And they're thinking, oh, you know, we don't know what time he's talking about and they
forgot about it.
Now they're going to the tomb. To fulfill the custom. To fulfill the rites. Because something is
incomplete.
Something is remaining. They feel guilty in their hearts. They have this guilt complex. Something is incomplete. According to my faith, all the customs and requirements are not fulfilled. And so to give their hearts pacification. To bring peace to their own hearts. To complete the work these sisters
went.
To fulfill the requirements and customs. They don't know what has happened. They don't know that Jesus has already risen up. Hallelujah. Whether the customs are fulfilled or not, Jesus has completed the work. According to his promise on the third day, Jesus is already risen. The sisters are worried about the customs. Oh, my law, my requirement has not been fulfilled. I don't know what you feel about this. But if tonight Jesus comes, if as you leave this place, there's a rapture that takes place. Do you feel in your heart that something is incomplete, something still remains?
Or
do you feel everything is done properly? Whatever needed to be fulfilled, the requirements have done. The service I had to do, I have done. The prayer that I had to pray, I have prayed. Have you done what you were supposed to do to the Lord? Is there something where you feel if I had a chance I would do it?
Oh, man mein kitni feeling rahega baad.
And you feel guilty later?
Man ke andar jo hai si jo shanka si rahegi agar mere ko mauka aata to main ye kar leta ya ye kar leti.
And you feel this doubt in your heart that if I had a chance I would do this or that.
Bhaino ke man mein tha.
The sisters had it.
Andhera bahut hai.
Oh, it's dark.
Koi bhai bhi saath mein nahi hai.
No brothers with us.
Qabristan jana hai.
We gotta go to the graveyard.
Jo man mein use pura karna hai mujhe.
But what we need to do is fulfill that.
Nahi to mere andar bhavna si rahegi.
I have this feeling.
Man mein khayal se rahenge.
I will be left with this
thought. Pura kar dena chahiye tha mujhe.
We should have fulfilled it.
Mujhe ye kaam ko complete karna chahiye.
I should have completed it.
Ye maine vaada Yeshu ke saath kiya tha.
I made this promise.
Ye baat maine pehle se vaada kiya tha.
I had made this promise.
Ye maine tere liye ye karunga ye karungi.
Lord, I would do this for you.
पर मेरे को पूरा करने का मौका नहीं मिला है.
I did not get a chance to fulfill.
आज आखिरी टाइम है.
This is the last time.
तीसरा दिन गुजर जाएगा.
The third day will pass.
चौथे में नहीं हो सकेगा. चौथे में नहीं ये हो सकेगा.
There is no place to do this on the fourth day.
पांचवें में नहीं हो सकेगा.
You can't do it on the fifth day.
तो आज पूरा करना है.
You have to do it today.
उन्होंने सुबह उठी है.
They got up.
हिम्मत बांध
They took courage.
मसाले खरीदे हैं.
They bought their spices.
वस्तुएं खरीदी हैं.
They got all everything.
सब मिक्स किया है.
They mixed them up.
सुबह उठी हैं.
They got up in the morning.
जल्दी जा रही हैं.
And they're walking.
Let's do it what unfinished had.
जो बात अधूरी है उसे पूरा करें.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
अगर आपके मन में कुछ है ऐसा कुछ भी.
If there is something like that in your heart,
then you should have done
something. You should have done
something. You should have done something.
You should have done something.
You should have done something. You should
have done something. You should
have done something. You should have done something.
You should have done something. You should have done something. You
should have done something. You should have done something. You should have
done something. You must do it today because tomorrow may be too late.
आज करना आसान होगा कल शायद देर हो जाए आपके लिए.
You must do it today. It may be easy tomorrow may be too late.
बहनों ने दलेरी करी है. दलेरी करी बहनों ने.
The sisters took courage.
हिम्मत बांधी है.
They were courageous.
भाई सो रहे थे.
The brothers were sleeping.
उनको कोई परवाह नहीं थी.
They didn't care.
डर था बड़ा.
They were just scared.
खौफ था बड़ा.
They were afraid.
अरे बाद में कर लेंगे.
We'll do it later.
माफी मांग लेंगे.
We'll ask forgiveness.
अरे ये बहनों ने हिम्मत बांधी है.
But these sisters had courage.
Oh, I need to finish something which is not complete yet.
कुछ बात है जो अधूरी है मुझे पूरा करना है.
रसुरक्षण हमें क्या याद दिलाता है?
What does resurrection teach us?
जो खुदा उनके साथ पूरा करना उसको पूरा करना है.
What you need to fulfill with the Lord or for the Lord, you must do it.
नहीं तो अगला साल फिर आएगा.
Otherwise, next year
फिर Good Friday आएगा.
Again Good Friday.
फिर Easter आएगा.
Again Easter will come.
फिर उधर जाएगा.
Again we'll go.
फिर हम इकट्ठे होंगे.
Again we'll gather.
फिर गीत गाएंगे.
Again we'll sing.
फिर घर चले जाएंगे.
We'll go home.
पर जो काम है वो उधर ही रह जाएगा.
But the work will remain incomplete.
Celebration का मायना क्या है?
What does celebration mean?
कुछ काम करना है.
That you gotta do something.
कुछ action पूरा करना है.
You need to fulfill an
action. कुछ वादे पूरे करने हैं.
Fulfill a promise.
कुछ प्रार्थना पूरी करनी है.
Some prayers you have to do.
खुदावंद के साथ किए प्रतिज्ञाओं को पूरा उतारना है जिंदगी में.
The vows that you made to the Lord you must fulfill.
हमारे लिए celebration है.
For us it's a celebration.
उसके लिए celebration नहीं था.
For him it was not a celebration.
उसके लिए बड़ी हिम्मत की बात थी.
For them it was a courageous
thing. की बात थी.
For them it was a courageous
thing. जोखिम था.
For them there was a risk.
उनके लिए बड़ा dangerous काम था.
For them it was a dangerous work.
और हम क्या करते हैं?
What do we do?
Easy वाला करते हैं.
We do the easy part.
Oh, celebration.
आओ मनाएं कुछ.
हमारे पास time नहीं है काम पूरा करने के लिए और काम हमारे पास.
We don't have time for fulfilling the other works of God.
अरे Easter word Bible में नहीं है.
We don't have the word Easter
word. Good Friday Bible में नहीं है.
Good Friday is not the Bible.
यीशु ने कहा क्या कहा था?
Who said this? Where
did he say it?
What was it?
मैं इसको नहीं मानता.
I don't believe this.
मैं इसको नहीं मानता.
I don't believe that.
हम मसीही लोग आपस में बहस करने में ज़्यादा time लगा देते हैं.
We Christians spend too much time arguing.
और ज़्यादातर मसीही लोग किसके साथ बहस करते हैं?
And who do Christians debate with?
Thank you, brother.
आपस में.
सही कह रहे हैं.
मसीही लोग मसीहियों के साथ बहस करते हैं.
The Christians debate with Christians.
एक denomination वाला दूसरे denomination के साथ बहस.
One denomination argues with the other.
But something is undone for us.
लेकिन कुछ काम अधूरा है.
यीशु ने कहा था.
Jesus said.
जाकर दूसरों को बताओ कि मैं जी उठा हूँ.
Go and tell others that I have risen up.
कईयों को अभी पता नहीं है.
Some people
say. कईयों को सामर्थ को चखा नहीं है.
Some people are not tasted his power.
कईयों ने उसकी कुवत को जिंदगी में उतारा नहीं है.
We don't have time to do that work.
और बहस में लगे रहते हैं.
And we are busy arguing.
ये बहनें किसी की नहीं सुनी हैं.
These sisters have listened to us.
अपने नींद को त्यागा है.
They forsook
their sleep. कंफर्ट को आराम को त्यागा है.
They forgot about their comfort.
पहले वो पूरा करना जो अधूरा रह गया है.
First let us fulfill what is incomplete.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Something has to be finished जो हमारे लिए अधूरा रह गया है.
कुछ काम बाकी है. That has to be finished.
नहीं तो anxiety रहती है, शंका रहती है, मन में जो है व्याकुलता सी रहती
है. Otherwise your heart will be anxious and worried.
दूसरी बात मैं यहाँ पर देखता हूँ.
The second thing I see.
वहाँ पर जो है संतरी पहरा लगाने के लिए लगा दिए गए थे.
You know they had stationed soldiers to guard the tomb.
मत्ती अंजील 28 अध्याय 2 की 4 आयत में लिखा हुआ है इनके बारे में.
Matthew 28 verse 2 to 4 it says about them.
कि वहाँ पर जो है गार्ड करने के लिए उनकी रक्षा करने के लिए पर जो है उनकी कब्र पर मोहर लगाई है और संतरी गार्ड कर रहे हैं ध्यान रख रहे हैं.
That at the tomb of Jesus they put a stone, they sealed it, and then they had soldiers stationed to guard it.
उनको डर है कहीं ये उनकी बॉडी को चुरा के ना ले जाए.
Because they are afraid, what if the followers of Jesus steal the body?
अब ये सब में नहीं आ रहे बॉडी चुराने से क्या होता है?
But you don't know what they're worried about. What will happen if someone steals the
body? शरीर चुराया जा सकता है.
You can steal a body.
पर अंदर जान कौन डाले?
But who's going to put life in it?
अरे भाई बॉडी की तुम रक्षा करोगे?
If you're going to protect the body,
बॉडी को कौन क्या करेगा?
Who's going to do something with
it?
Outside the body is dead, inside the body is
dead.
Unless there is life, there is no
miracle.
There is no fear that the body, they are fearful that the body will be
dead. The
Bible says, what they were not ready for, what miracle they were not ready for, they had to see it on by force. No one came to steal. The disciples were so fearful, they were hiding indoors. They were not even coming out. But the army of God shows up. The Bible says the angel shows up. He moves the stone.
Big storm.
And there's a huge storm that takes place.
And then the power of the Holy Ghost comes there.
And the power of the Spirit of God raises Jesus. And Jesus rises from the dead. What they were afraid of never happened. Something bigger happened. It says when Jesus rose up from the dead, they fell down. They felt people were
going to
steal. But they did not realize God would show up. They didn't know that the Holy Spirit would show up. They did not know that the angels would come. What does resurrection tell us? Some people don't believe. Some people are so afraid of the power of God they don't believe. Let the people be.
Debate.
Don't fight in the
debate.
You will spend so much time
wasting.
You go and pray.
Present
your request to God.
Because
what God will do, no
one else can do.
The gods never believed.
The gods never believed
in Jesus.
That day
they saw the miracle.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Your enemies who are against you and are not ready for it will see a miracle. Don't be afraid and don't argue. Begin to pray to the Lord. God will send His power. God will send His power. God will send His angel. And then your enemies will be shut up, they'll be quiet.
Unke paas kuch aur kahani nahi hogi jab tak wo dekh na sake.
And then they will not be able to make any other story because they'll see for
themselves.
The third thing I see in the book of Luke, chapter
24, verse 1 to 3.
Again, this is about the sisters where early in the morning they go and find the stone rolled away. What was the expectation?
Dead body milegi.
They'll find the dead body.
और वहाँ पर जाकर सामग्री लगाएंगे हम.
And we'll apply the spices.
और अपना काम करके घर पे आ जाएंगे.
And we'll do our work and come home.
और वहाँ पर जाती हैं.
They go there.
और होता क्या है?
And what happens?
उनको मुर्दा शरीर नहीं मिलता.
They don't find the dead body.
यीशु मसीह का शरीर नहीं मिलता है.
They don't find the body of Jesus.
तो उसके बदले में क्या हो जाती हैं?
What do they find?
बाल करती निराश हो जाती हैं.
They get upset the Bible.
परेशान हो जाती हैं.
They get worried.
क्योंकि उनको मुर्दा शरीर नहीं वहाँ पर मिला.
Because they did not find the dead body.
अरे मोशे का खुशी नहीं है.
They are not happy about the miracle.
तो यीशु जीवता उस बात का तो खुशी हो नहीं रही है.
Jesus has risen up. They're not rejoicing.
परेशानी क्या है?
What is the problem?
यीशु का शरीर नहीं मिला.
Don't have the body.
हमें मुर्दा शरीर चाहिए.
We want the dead body.
कुछ लोगों को मुर्दा चीजों से बड़ा लगाव रहता.
Some people are so attached to dead things.
उनके सामने जीवित जिंदा मौजा होता उस पर तो ध्यान नहीं होता. मुर्दा चीजों में उनका ध्यान खोया रहता.
Even a living miracle takes place right before their eyes. They're not looking at the miracle. They're looking at the dead thing. Looking for the dead thing.
उनको अपने हिसाब से जो मन में प्लान बनाया वो नहीं पूरा हुआ उनका.
They have a picture in their mind and they're questioning why
picture.
Some people get so upset.
Amin, aise nahi bola.
Then you didn't say it like this.
Hum to aise Genesis ki kehte hain.
We say praise the Lord like this.
Hum to hamare baap ki dua end mein karte hain, middle mein ko karte hain.
We say our Lord's prayer at the end. Why you sing it in the middle?
Ye to geet ka tarz aise gaate, hum to aise gaya karte the.
You sing this song like this. We used to sing it like that.
Aur cheezon mein kho jayenge jo real kaam usme jo hai dhyan nahi hota.
They get stuck in old things, traditions, and they forget about the real thing.
Kaun kaisa ga raha hai, kaise chal raha hai, wo chhodo, aap dhyan do ki khuda aur yeshu kahan par hai.
Who is singing? How walking? How forget about those things? Ask where Jesus is.
Aap zinda yeshu ki huzuri se khush ho.
Be pleased with the presence of the living Jesus.
Yeshu ke naam se khush ho.
Be glad about the name of Jesus.
Hame khush to nahi hone ki Yeshu zinda ho gaya, kar rahe dead body chahiye, hum to masale leke aaye.
These sisters are not rejoicing that Jesus risen from the dead. They're like, oh, we brought all these spices.
Hame to apna dastoor pura karna hai.
We gotta do our requirement.
Hum saath milke taiyari kari hai.
We prepared all night.
Kitne masale taiyar kare hain.
We used so many spices.
Mehngi mehngi sugandhit vaste humne khareedi hain.
We bought such expensive sweet spices.
Yeshu zinda ho gaya. पहले तो हमारा डेड बॉडी लेके आ, हमें तो अपना काम
Jesus rose up and went, let him go. First give us the dead body to apply the spices.
हमारा रिचुअल पूरा होना चाहिए.
Our custom, our ritual,
हमारा दस्तूर पूरा होना चाहिए.
First our tradition.
हमने तो ऐसे ही सीखा है.
That's what we have learned.
ये यहूदी बात में ऐसे ही होता है.
This what happens when a Jewish scripture.
तीसरे दिन जाके बात की सामग्री लगाई जाती है.
On the third day you must apply the spices.
मालिक तुम कहाँ हो, ठेकेदार कहाँ हो, हमारा डेड बॉडी दो हमें वापस.
Hey gardener, where are you? Owner of the graveyard, where are you? Return the dead body.
मुर्दा शरीर चाहिए.
We want the dead body.
जिंदा होंगे यीशु भी चाहिए. मुर्दा tradition को पूरा करना है.
Jesus is alive. We don't want him. We want that dead tradition.
मैं चाहता हूँ इस ईस्टर में आपको मेरे ख्याल बदल जाए.
I want you to change our perspective during this Easter.
आपका क्या दस्तूर है?
What is the custom?
आपने किन traditions में आप परमिश आपकी क्यों ना हुई हो?
You maybe have raised in certain conditions.
आपके पासवान ने कैसा भी पुरानी जिंदगी में क्यों ना सिखाया हो?
Your pastor from your previous life may have done anything.
आप ये focus करो अगर यीशु जिंदा हो गया तो आप यीशु की ध्यान करेंगे.
You must focus on the fact that Jesus is alive and you must pay attention to him.
अपना पुराना मरा हुआ मजहब एक साइड में करें.
Take your dead old religion and put it aside.
अपने रीति रिवाज के साइड में रख
दें. Take your customs and rituals and put them aside.
इस ध्यान इस बात पर ध्यान दें.
Pay attention to this.
यीशु तो जिंदा हो गया, आप कहाँ हैं?
Jesus is alive. Where are you?
मुझे डेड बॉडी नहीं चाहिए.
I don't want the dead body.
मुझे जिंदा चाहिए.
I want the risen Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
यीशु वहाँ पर जीवित होकर आ जाते हैं.
Jesus rises up and shows up.
तो यीशु वहाँ पर खड़े थे.
Jesus was standing there.
मरियम कहती हैं यीशु को.
Mary says Jesus.
माली जी.
Gardener.
आपने हमारे यीशु को चुराया है.
You stolen our Jesus.
Please कहाँ रखा है, हमें दे दो.
Please return him to us where we kept him.
जब आदमी का ध्यान दस्तूरों पर होता है, रीतों रवायतों पर होता है, तो यीशु की पहचान नहीं आती.
When someone is so focused on customs and rituals, they don't recognize Jesus.
अगर ज्यादा ध्यान सामग्री पर, मसालों पर लगाते रहेंगे तो यीशु सामने होते हुए भी आप पहचान नहीं पाएंगे.
If you spend all your attention on the spices and the customs, Jesus will be right before you.
यीशु सामने खड़े हैं. जिंदा खुदा सामने खड़े हैं.
The risen Lord Jesus is right there before them.